guys ever tried to build one of these? They're impossible. And I know this because there was actually a brief phase of my childhood where I got way into building houses of cards. That sounds like a weird hobby to suddenly have, but I can explain. When I was in like 6th or 7th grade, a movie came out that my family loved, Maverick. It was a Western starring Mel Gibson, before he went crazy, and the whole movie centered around this big poker tournament. Now, my family watched this movie all the time. It was like a ritual for us. So at some point, us kids got the idea that we should play poker as a family. So all 5 of us sat around the table while my dad tried to coach us all on how to play 5-card draw, and we learned something very important. Poker with kids is boring. Seriously, the game looked so fun in the movie, but we were bored out of our minds, like 2 hands in. So we all got frustrated, ended the game, and everyone just went their separate ways. But I stayed at the table. Here was this now unused deck of cards, and I was familiar with the concept of a house of cards, and I thought, how hard can that be? Turns out, it's really hard. I started to build, and then I bumped one little card, and the whole thing crashed down. Somehow, that only made me more determined to successfully build a decent house of cards. So I sat there building and failing, and building some more and failing some more. It became this fixation for me, and I was not going to be satisfied until I had pulled this off. I spent weeks using most of my free time trying to master the house of cards. I know, I have problems. Now, I tell you all that not so you can have a new weird hobby, though by all means, go home and give it a shot if you want to. I tell you that because I cannot think of a clearer picture of what lying does to our lives than a house of cards. We've been in a series called Foot in Mouth, where we've been talking all about our words and what happens when we're reckless with them, when we don't speak the way God instructs us to. And let me tell you, as a guy who routinely puts his foot in his mouth, words can cause a lot of damage. And some of the biggest damage that can be done with words happens when we lie. Now, before you start to check out and think, oh, I'm not a liar, I'm good. Time to stop listening and begin contemplating if T-Swift will ever find true love. Hold on, just a second. I bet most of us think we're pretty honest just because we aren't a pathological liar, right? I mean, as long as you're not that person who is just clearly making stuff up all the time that no one can take seriously, and we all know someone like that, don't we? Then you must be pretty honest, right? Well, I'm sorry to be the bearer of bad news, but unless you have simply never told a lie, never bent the truth a little bit, never held back some of the information to try and make things easier for yourself, you're a liar. I'm a liar. We're all liars. And here's why this is a big issue. It's not about simply lying and whether you're saying words that are true or not. It's an issue of trust. Lying is a relational problem. When you lie, it destroys trust. And trust is a fundamental necessity in having a real relationship with somebody. And the scary thing about trust is that trust takes years to build and seconds to destroy. It's a fragile thing. It's a house of cards. That's why Solomon told us in Proverbs 19:5, a false witness will not go unpunished, nor will a liar escape. Now, a false witness is just another name for a liar, so this passage is basically saying the same thing in 2 different ways. Lies always catch up with the liar. They always come out eventually, and the relational damage that is done can take years to repair. You know, let's look at this another way. Let's say every card in this house of cards is a thing you have said to people you value in your life. A lot of these you've said to your parents, some to teachers and friends. With each interaction and each statement, you are building trust. You're building their perception of who you are. Now, most of these statements are true statements. And now, just a couple of them are probably lies. Now, let's say, for example, you didn't do your homework, but you want to go hang out with your friends, so you tell your parents that you did. All right, it's just one little lie. You'll tell the truth from here on out. After all, you're an honest person. Well, the next day, your teacher is collecting the homework you didn't do, and you realize your grade is going to be affected, and your parents are going to find out you lied, so you make up an excuse for your teacher. You had to visit your sick grandma last night, and she believes you and gives you an extra day to complete the assignment. Okay, just 2 little lies in here in this growing tower. You'll fill in around it with the truth, and it's all going to be fine. After all, you're an honest person. Now, you could leave it here with 2 little lies, and as long as your parents and teacher never see each other, you know, like at a parent-teacher conference where they might formally sit down in private and have a chance to chat, you'll probably be okay. But when your friends have the idea to ditch 4th period, you know that you already have a built-in excuse with that teacher. You go and tell her that your grandma isn't doing so well and that you're gonna miss class that day. It's okay, you're really an honest person, right? So you and your buddies are hanging out off campus during fourth period feeling like you own the world when it dawns on you. Even though you told your teacher that excuse, she's still gonna mark you absent. Eventually, someone in the office will notice that unexcused absence and call your parents, and you're gonna be busted. So you panic. You decide your only option is to call yourself in. You pull out your phone, you call the school office, and in your deepest dad voice, you try and excuse yourself from fourth period because you had to visit your sick grandma. Boom, done, in the clear, and you're still an honest person? And then you get home later that day. Your mom has that look on her face that lets you know you're in big trouble. Dad is home from work early, and it doesn't look like he's there to surprise you and take you to Disneyland. They have you sit down and tell you how the school office called to verify your absence when a suspiciously young-sounding voice called to excuse it. They tell you the office also asked how Grandma was doing, which seemed odd since Grandma is totally fine, and suddenly they start to tug at all these lies. They're asking questions, you don't have good answers, and eventually they get to the bottom of it, they pull out the lie, and the whole thing comes crashing down. You're grounded forever. And you were such an honest person. So sad. But here's what I want you to notice. It's not like just the lie cards come out of this tower. All those cards that were true things that you had said to your parents, teachers, and friends all come crashing down with it. That trust is shattered. You spent years being an honest person and building up all that trust, and in this one moment, that trust was gone. They have no choice but to question every single thing you've ever told them. They can't help it. Trust takes years to build and seconds to destroy. It will be a very long time before your parents really trust you again, before they're willing to let you go hang out with your friends because they simply can't trust that you'll be where you said you'd be, doing what you said you'd do. Students, let me tell you something I learned the hard way when I was growing up, and I see even more clearly now that I'm a parent. Even when my kids do something wrong, I'm never as mad or disappointed as I would be if they lied to me about it. People make mistakes, and parents get that. So when you do something wrong, but you come clean and deal with it, they're going to be much more forgiving. Because at that point, it's not a trust issue. They can still trust you because you were willing to be honest despite the consequences of your mistake. But when you do what you shouldn't do, and you lie to cover it up, that's when parents lose their ever-loving minds. That's when trust gets destroyed, when the house of cards comes crashing down, and when that relational damage will take months, maybe years to repair. So, here's what I want to challenge you with today. Go home and have a tough conversation. If you are sitting here right now, and you know there is still something floating out there, some lie you've told that hasn't been found out yet, don't let it sit there in the middle of your house of cards just waiting to bring the whole thing crashing down. Go to that person, tell them the truth, and be willing to take the consequences. Jesus himself told us that those who live by the truth come into the light. They don't hide and hope that what they did doesn't get found out. They come clean, deal with it, and move on. I can promise you, whatever happens and whatever punishment may be handed out will be nothing compared to what happens when that lie is found out and trust is destroyed. More than that, you'll be amazed at the level of peace that comes over you when you've done the right thing and that lie isn't hanging over your head anymore. Set yourself free from the fear and the worry that you're living in, knowing that you're just one question away from being found out, and tell the truth. Lies always catch up with the liar, unless the liar takes action and confesses first. That action will build and preserve trust, which will make everything in that relationship better. Guys, don't get found out. Be the honest person you want to be and live in the peace that only comes with living the way Jesus calls us to.